In the last video, we observed the discussion of the simulation of Thomson's cathode ray tube experiments. Based on those experiments, Thomson made a claim that the particles are negatively charged, smaller than atoms, and that those small negatively charged particles came from different types of atoms. Students were then asked to draw revised models of atomic structure that could account for Thomson's observations and claims. The students drew these models using the draw tool on a computer. I then projected the drawings the students made and used them to guide a discussion. Again, the models are anonymous, so students focus on evaluating the content of the models rather than on other students' work.
In the models of the atoms that you draw for number 12, your models need to be able to explain those three different things. That there's negative pieces, that those pieces are smaller than an atom, and that those pieces could come from any kind of atom. Right? So let's take a look at the models you guys drew. So what do we think? This model indicate, does it match with the evidence? Okay, so what's it showing? So we have the electrons are labeled. They are smaller. Is it showing that they're negative?
No.
So maybe we could add a little bit more information here to indicate they're negatively charged. Okay, so if this is our atom and these are all negatively charged, what would the charge of the whole atom be?
Well, are like the protons or something positively charged and then the neutrons neutral?
So what do you mean by those? Protons and neutrons, what are those? What evidence do we have to support that?
My science textbook says it's
not safe. That's not evidence.
Yeah, it is.
Nope.
They can't publish that if it's wrong.
Oh, yes. Sure they can. There's mistakes in textbooks all the time. Let's take a the experiments we've done though. If we think back to the beginning of the year, we were just working with different charged objects, right? Was the only charge negative? Were all the objects negative? What else did we have?
Positive
and neutral objects. And what did we see when we tested the neutral objects?
They attracted to both.
So if those objects were made out of atoms that had negative electrons, can we explain why they would be neutral and why they would attract to both? So if I have a neutral object and it's attracting to a negative, what would that tell you about the neutral object that's attracting to negative? How can we explain why a neutral object would attract to a negative?
Because neutral objects attract to these charges.
That was the pattern we saw, but what could we, how could we explain why that might happen, or how that happens? Jack said maybe there's positives and negatives inside the neutral atom. There we go. This one has positives and negatives, right? So if I brought a negatively charged object up to this neutral atom, would we see an attraction? Hey, and from where's the attraction coming from? Hey, where's the attraction coming from? My negatively charged object in this atom.
Because we know that neutral objects are attracted to charged objects.
So that's the pattern again, but we're trying to explain why that happens. So why would this neutral atom be attracted to a negative object?
Because it has positive particles in it.
So the positive particles within this atom could be the ones that are attracted to the negative object?
Yeah.
How about if I brought a positive object up to this?
The negative particles could be attracted to the positive.
Okay. So evidence from Thomson's experiment that there are negative particles inside atoms. So if there are negative particles, maybe also positive particles. So let's think, does this picture of an atom account for what Thomson saw? Are there small negative pieces? Are the negative pieces smaller than the atom itself?
Yeah.
Would the overall atom be neutral?
What are you thinking, Colin?
This whole atom, neutral, positive, or negative? What do you think?
Well, maybe it has more negative atoms, or more negative parts to it, so it'd be a negative atom.
Okay, so if you actually counted them? You
yeah.
Counted them up? So how many negatives did you get?
Nine.
And the positives?
Eight.
So because there's an extra negative,
yes.
It'd be overall negative? Yeah, Hannah?
Oh, Kelly, what you said, I was just saying, I think it depends on how many electrons there are compared to positive particles. Because if there's more electrons that are negatively charged, then the whole atom is probably going to be negatively charged. Then if there's more protons, then it'll be positively charged.
Okay. So like Colin and Hannah were saying, maybe if we compare the number of positives to the number of negatives, that can give us a sense of what the overall atom is?
It just depends on how much it's charged. Positively charged atoms can be stronger than
so like this could be a stronger positive than this is a negative. So like it could be like two of these equals one of those or vice versa. Okay. So maybe it's not just a straight one-to-one comparison. One could be stronger than the other. Okay. In general, does this model of an atom do a good job of explaining what Thomson saw? That we could get these negative pieces from passing that electricity through that metal plate. Yeah,
ma'am? No neutrons.
Did Thomson have anything about neutral particles coming out of that positive plate? Or sorry, out of the metal plate?
No, but did he know about that before?
No, so before Thomson, they thought the atom was just like a solid, like a basketball or something, or a baseball, just like a solid sphere. So this one says, electrons are part of an atom. So the ray is separating the electrons from the nucleus. So a nucleus is something we haven't introduced yet. What's the nucleus? What do you mean by that? The center of the whole atom? Okay. So and then the electrons are part of the atom. And then it says the ray is separating the electrons from the atom. So these are getting kind of pulled off when we send the electricity through them. So what do you guys think? Count for all of his evidence. How about the fact that the electrons bent up towards the positive plate? So what could we add to this to make that a little bit more clear? Maybe the charges, or we could say in the key, maybe including clarifying that the electrons are negative. If we assume the electrons are negative, then does it explain all of that? Maybe. Similar ideas as the last one, protons and neutrons and electrons. It says the electrons circle the atom. I added the negative charge of atoms. So this is explain that there are little pieces that could come out from the atom within the cathode to make up the cathode ray. Those little pieces would be negatively charged. So which piece would be coming off from this model? The red ones, the green ones, or the blue ones?
The red ones.
The red ones. And how about with this whole atom? Neutral charge, negative charge, positive charge? Neutral, why?
There's
an even amount of everything. So maybe they're all balancing each other out. Okay, any other thoughts? Positive, negative, neutral? So the only ones that are labeled are the negative charges on the electrons. So if these have charges, they're not labeled, we wouldn't know. Okay.
I just want to reiterate that in this discussion, the images the students were discussing were images the students made using the draw tool on a computer. Students were also able to use their earlier observations to begin to evaluate different drawings that they created. In the next video clip, we'll see another simulation that was used to give additional evidence so students could further revise their models.